full house here at Studio 10 today, and there certainly is a strange energy in the room. Yeah. How we feel? Are we nervous?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm nervous.
Of course, everyone is here, not just for us, but for psychic medium John Edward, who is going to do his only live reading while he's in Australia. A live television audience. John, I'll let you...
So basically when I come to you, you're gonna hear me giving you information, and you're gonna hear stuff like people are above you, they're to the side, they're below you. It's frames of references, so above you would be older, to your side would be around the same age, and then below you would be younger. Names do come through, I could be off by the name, I won't be off by the initial or what the name sounds like, and everybody has a person or one person that they would like to hear from. I might not get that person, so I need you to listen to what's coming through. During the show, I was getting information and I was jotting some stuff down, so here's my scorekeeper to see if I got it right or not, but I was being pulled to that section, so I'm gonna just stand up so I can come closer to you over there, if that's okay. I was getting pulled to this section, and I feel like there's a father figure reference that they want me to bring through, so I don't know if there's a father figure for you guys who have passed, but to me it would be like father, uncle, grandfather. There's a J or a G name that they want me to highlight, so that's either somebody who's living or passed, but it's in that section over there. Does that make sense? Can you take, we're gonna get a mic to you so that we can hear you.
Get my father-in-law.
Passed.
Yeah, passed.
Okay, and there's got to be a J or G name that's connected to that.
Giovanni, but we call him Johnny.
Okay, there's a five connection that they wanted me to talk about. So the five connection to me would either be the month of May, because that's the fifth month, or the fifth of a month, birthday or anniversary. But there's something five related that they want me to talk about. And he has to have a child that's with him, or there's a younger energy that's passed. So there's a younger person that's connected to him, correct?
Yeah, we had five kids.
Okay, and is one of the kids passed, or is there...
Two of them.
Okay, somebody passed from either something head-related, or there was something that...
That was him.
Okay, so there's something head-related that comes up with it. And Catherine or Karen, there's a C or K name, but it's a nickname, not a real name. So it's like somebody was known as a C or... I hear the K sound.
Yeah, the younger daughter, Selena.
That would be an S? This is
That's a
K? No, but it phonetically would sound like an S to me, so I can't accept that. It's got to be like a K name. Think like Coco or Kiki or Kira or something that's got like a K sounding name. And then they're telling me to tell you that is his wife also passed?
Yes.
Because I see him with his contemporary, which would be the wife energy. Yeah. And somebody had congestive heart failure, and that means like it's where they fill up with fluids or there's like a heaviness in the chest in some way. And that was either his sister or somebody that would be like a sister figure to somebody that's here, because they're talking about the sister figure. Now, is there some reference to him losing a sister as well as his wife?
I think because there was a lot of family overseas in Italy, but there was one that went...
And do you know her?
It's my sister.
Okay, because I feel like I need to bring you into this. And I'm supposed to talk to you about, is it your mom that's passed?
No.
Then who would be the aunt your name for? Or the older female that the name's passed down? Or who passed the name down? They're showing me parallel lines. So when I see parallel lines, it usually means that a name is passed down. But this...
My auntie's daughter is
Crystal. Say a little bit louder.
My auntie's daughter is Crystal, and my daughter is Crystal.
Okay, and is your aunt passed?
Yes.
Okay, so that aunt, C or K name, is connected to you as well, correct?
Yes. Oh, yeah,
okay.
Too.
Oh, of course.
So, see how you're all connected. It's just how I have to get it in my head. So the C or K name is telling me to come to you to acknowledge how the name has been passed down. So you both have the same children with the same name.
Yes.
Now, I don't know if there's some reference to you going to school for healthcare or somebody dealing with doing something healthcare related.
Crystal is.
Yeah. Okay, so that's just my way of backing up the information. Why do I do it like this? And the reason why I do it like this is that for all the people who are gonna tweet me that I am not actually doing this, we've never met, correct?
No,
I've not spoken to you. Okay, I just wanna be very, very clear. One of the most important things is validation. And what this does is shows that your father-in-law, your mother-in-law, with their children, and connected to your aunt who's passed, it's their way of saying that they're around you guys and they see what's going on. Did you know that somebody's expanding their family? Like, did you know that there's either like an engagement and somebody's kind of getting together, or there's a marriage and people are expanding? Do you know this?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's been announced already?
Yes.
Okay, why am I feeling like we had to put it off? Like, what did we have to put off? Like, did somebody put off their date, or did they put off doing this?
They're waiting because she's pregnant.
They had to put something off. Like, I feel like, oh, it can't happen now. It has to happen then. There's like a putting off of something.
Well, she can't have the baby when she was supposed to, because then it falls on your birthday.
So they decided to put it off?
No, the wedding.
The wedding. Well, no, the wedding's in April, the baby's due October. But she found out yesterday she might have to have a Caesar, and I said that'll be good because then it won't be on her birthday.
All right, because so this see, this is what I talk about. I talk about this being a current. It's a current event.
Yes,
it's their way of saying to you,
yes,
we see what's going on around you. And if I could be so bold, and I know this is live television, and if you don't want to go there, it's absolutely okay. You can be like, John, I understand that. You were saying like it's you wanted to keep things separate. You like things to be kept separate. In other words, you wouldn't want to have two people. It's like having your birthday on Christmas. It's not like
Yeah, exactly. I told her I don't want. She can't have the baby.
Oh, okay. So
I told her. Yeah.
It's all good now.
Yeah.
I know. We saw a very cute video early in the show of the little dog. Mm, you know, messing around with the cat. They're telling me that you have one of those passed. So somebody's got a dog that's there.
Yes.
Yeah. So they're telling me that dog is there. And I'm supposed to always talk about that when, and it's so funny because I just named all these different people in your family and the reaction the dog got was bigger than the people. So no matter where I go, it's the same. I'm supposed to talk about either somebody had a mishap on the big boat or there was a mishap in the family on the boat or is there a joke about the mishap on the boat?
She was just on a cruise.
I just got off a boat.
Yeah.
Was there a mishap?
There was a lot.
Like 20.
So hypothetically, could we say that there was a reference of, I don't want to say man overboard, but could we say that there was an issue where maybe somebody had
they were kicked off the boat?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
It happened.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Was it somebody you were with?
No.
Indirectly?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Because I have a feeling of good riddance.
Like, yes, he's, yes.
Like good riddance.
Yes.
You know, I don't know who, if you had to ask for someone today, if you had a place like, you know, oh, I'd like to hear from someone, would it have been your father-in-law to come through first?
I feel like he's in our house all the time.
Yeah, because I feel like he's making me feel like, you know, it's no
and
big deal.
And I just
deal.
Feel so glad now that you've said that I'm not going nuts and I can go home and tell my husband.
You're not nuts. But why is your husband, I'm just passing on what I'm seeing and I say this, I'm not a doctor, I can't diagnose. I just want to know why your husband's not taking care of his stomach stuff. Like,
I don't know about his stomach stuff.
No. Isn't he the person that, maybe I got the wrong guy. Is there another son that he has that has like really bad acid?
One of my sons, yes.
Like really bad acid and stuff?
Yes.
Why is that not checked?
Oh, it is. He's been to a specialist and that about that and he's on treatment now for it.
It's happening.
Yeah.
Okay, so maybe it's just them showing to me. It's like, okay, we see it happening.
Yeah.
I always err on the side of, let's be cautious. Let's look at it. Maybe ask him if he's taking his meds, maybe see if there's been any change in that. I don't know if he lives in a different, like I know I'm standing in Sydney, but is he's in a different part of the country or if there's in a different place?
No, he lives with me, but he's going soon.
I see.
He's moving soon.
Away.
From home, yes. Yeah. I don't want
okay,
to
so that's just Grandpa's way of looking after him. Thank you very, very much. I hope this helps.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Do not go anywhere. We are just getting started with psychic medium John Edwards. We'll be back with more live readings after the break.